Did you give this poor excuse for wine to young Bobbie?
Yes, and she was happy with the deal too.
Well, for your information, she's made herself very ill drinking this little money spinner of yours.
So? I didn't force her to drink it. I was merely doing her a favour.
Well, now, you're going to do us a favour. Give her a drink, Cass. Oh, no. That's not enough. You're going to drink all three bottles. Better get started, dear.
Mitchell?
Yeah, you can get me out of this rotten, crappy piss-pot hole.
That will be quite enough of that, young lady.
I'm sorry, I'm not feeling myself today. I'm a bit crook in the guts.
Do you want to see the doctor?
No, I'll be all right in a bit. Just leave me alone.
Not feeling yourself, eh? It wouldn't have anything to do with drink, I don't suppose.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, alcohol is strictly forbidden in here, Mitchell. You know that. You'll be put on a charge.
Look, there's no booze in here. You can't prove a thing.
No. You're probably right. But we'll put your case to the governor in the morning.
Will I give her the last bottle,
Min? Yeah! And then her insides will be as rotten as the rest of us.
Two should do her for the moment. We'll go to three if there's a next time.
What's going on here?
Oh, well, that is a charming little sight. Okay, Mason, get Stevens to herself.
Please, Miss Ferguson, I don't like drunks very much.
You bet.
Well, Donovan, so this is your doing, is it?
Oh, Miss Ferguson, I see you've been involved in this business as well.
What are you talking about?
Well, I've just come from Mitchell's cell, and she's drunk too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I just put Stevens on a charge for all of this. All right, you lot. Where did she get the booze from? Oh, yeah. I forgot. You never lag on your mates, do you?
Daphne, I really don't think the professional section's the right place for you to be looking for a job.
Oh, you're not wrong, Narelle. I can't even read half of them ads. Fat chance I've got of getting anything anyway.
Wally's right, Daphne. Depends where you look. Now, first you find out what you're interested in doing.
Oh, lots of things that you don't get paid for most of them. Oh, who cares? Does anyone want a coffee or something?
No, thank you.
No, suit yourself. I got it. Stay there.
Oh, no, come on, come on. Sit down
I took Susan. He wants her back. He's coming after me.
Daphne, get a cup of tea with you. Don't worry. We'll take care of everything.
But he's drunk. Whenever he's wagged,
don't worry. We're used to handling this sort of place as
oh,
well.
Oh, yeah, with a gun.
You look revolting, Stevens.
You're no oil-painting yourself.
Careful. You're already on one charge.
Yeah. Thanks for the backstab.
Small price to pay for staying in business.
Is that so? What's your contribution then?
Well, I'll get rid of the rest of the booze. And you tell the governor that only you were responsible for making the wine and that you and Mitchell decided to go on a bit of a binge.
Breaking your neck to be helpful, aren't you?
It's called power, Stevens. That's why I've got more to lose than you have.
What about Mitchell?
Don't worry about Mitchell. About to pay her a little visit. You know, Stevens, somehow throwing up really suits you.
It's not the first time he's threatened to kill me.
Well, are the police aware of this?
No, wouldn't do no good. It's only a domestic. Is he out there? Can you see him?
God, I can't see a bloody thing.
You sure he's coming?
Too right. He's not going to be happy till he kills me and takes Sue's back.
Come on, sit down, Claire. Now, how does he know you're at Driscoll House?
It's the first place he'd look. I was telling him for months I was going to take Susan Nick off here.
Well, is there any chance he might think you'd gone to family or friends?
What family? I haven't got any friends anymore either. That bastard took care of that.
Get your ass out of here, bitch! I want me killed!
He'll kill us. I know he will.
Police are on their way. Look, get away from the window. Come on. What's his name?
Wayne.
We'll get you upstairs. Daphne, get her up to mine.
I want to be near a door.
You stay near. Wally, stay with them. Shut the door. I'll see if I can reason with him.
I'm coming with you.
Well, all right then, but you stay absolutely still. Now, you go on, get upstairs. Are you there, Wayne? Your wife and baby are safe. Now, you don't want them hurt, do you?
Women is so safe.
Take them out to the other room, to the back. I'm opening the door, Wayne. And she's frightened for the baby now. Why can't we talk about this?
Get Susie and Claire now!
All right, just put the gun down. Somebody might get hurt.
Well, the doctor's on his way.
Well, she was damn lucky.
A graze is bad enough. You sure you're all right? Anything you want?
Oh, no, thanks, Wally. I'll be all right. Look, it's Claire I'm really worried about. Will her husband be released?
No, we'll be holding on to him for a while. You risk your life, Mrs. Doss. It's not very wise.
Oh, well, in this job, you have to make quick decisions. They may not be the right ones, but you can't regret them afterwards. No, I'm really worried about Claire. Look, if she comes back tonight, Wally, could you look after her? I'm feeling a bit shaken up.
We'll be in touch in a couple of days, Mrs. Dodds. Thanks again for your help, and you take care of yourself.
Oh, I couldn't be in better hands.
We'll check with your party manager.
Funny how Sonia didn't make it to tea, isn't it?
Yes, she must have gone right off her food.
And other things with a bit of luck.
Ah, good on you, Min. You're a beaut, top dog.
Yeah, I reckon B would really approve of you, Min. And with Cass to back you up, and we'll all support you, love.
Oh, yes.
Hang about. I hate to put the kibosh on this party, but someone's going to have to pay for it. I don't think the freak's going to let you bust up one of her little rackets.
I know that, Judy. But if we stick together, all of us, it's going to make it very difficult for her to break us down.
Oh, she's done it before. She just gets you on your own and you're a goner.
Lizzie's right, you know.
Well, we'll find a weak spot. And it'll take time. Meanwhile, we can all keep working at it together. At least the booze racket's almost under control.
Yeah, the trouble is the women want a bit of booze and gambling. Yeah, right. I mean, there's bugger all else to do in here. And if the only person they can get it from is the freak, well, what other choice have they got?
You know something, Judy? You could be right.
Well, what do you mean, Minnie? You're not going to give up, are you?
Never! There's going to be some healthy competition.
Oh, how are you going to do that, Minnie?
You wait and see. Ferguson won't know what's hit her.
Had a nice day, Mitchell?
You know, you disappoint me, Mitchell. I thought you were more sensible. But then you do know we when to keep quiet. And that's very important in here. So make sure you remember. Well?
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
I might just call back later. Just to make sure.
Mitchell, Stevens, you're with the governor first up, right?
Our Sonia didn't seem too happy about that.
Roberts, Mason, Parker, Donovan, Brent, Green, and Birdsworth to the laundry.
Oh, I don't think Jude's feeling very well, Miss Ferguson.
You've been hitting the slops too, have you, Bryant? Maybe you want to see the governor about something.
She needs to see the doc, Miss Ferguson.
Watch yourself, Birdsworth. You're not off the hook yet either.
Can I see the doctor?
You'll go at the bottom of the list and wait your turn like everyone else. Now get to the kitchen with Brody. The rest of you move out, quickly.
Excuse me, Miss Ferguson. Has there been any word about my appeal?
You've got to be joking. It's going to take more than an appeal to get the likes of you out of here.
Come on, Petra. We're wasting our time.
You know, Daphne, I think waitressing might be the answer for you. You're doing a top job.
That wouldn't be a hint for another cup of coffee, would it, by any chance?
Am I that easy to read?
Yes, at times.
Oh, I am sorry. I overslept. Must be the pills the doctor gave me.
Ah, it does you good to have a lay-in, especially when it's so deserved.
You're looking much better than you did last night, Mrs. Dodds. Do you want some brekkie or something?
Oh, no, thank you, Daphne. Just a coffee, thanks. That'd be nice.
Okay.
How's the arm? Much pain?
No, not really. Oh, the flowers are very nice. Where are they from?
The women bought them for you this morning.
Would you say the ice had finally broken?
I'd say so.
Well, I'm glad. It'll make working here so much easier.
Alice, I think it's time I moved on. No, no, let me explain. When I originally came here, it was to help my friend Judy. When she went back inside, I promised I'd stay on to see the place was run as she wanted it to be. But now I see nothing at all wrong with the way you're running the place. So I'm not really needed anymore.
Well, I know we'd get on much better now.
I know we would. But I think it's time.
All right. And thanks, Wally.
Mrs. Powell's given me Mrs. Barry's report. I've got no reason to doubt her. Now, once again, where did the alcohol come from?
It was just there. I can't remember who passed it to me.
You mean you won't remember?
I won't dob anyone in.
Stevens, what about you? Same story?
I made the alcohol, I sold it, and I take full responsibility. Now, can we get on with it?
I thought as much, Governor. She had quite a stash of it.
There's no report to indicate a cell search. How was it discovered?
Well, Stevens confessed in her drunken state that she had more hidden in the library. I found it and confiscated it. Well, there simply wasn't the staff available for a full cell search.
Did you check Birdsworth's cell?
This is my racket, not hers, and I have no need for partners.
All right, Stevens, I want the details of your operation.
Forget it. You've confiscated the lot and I've confessed. That's all you're getting out of me.
Both of you will be on cleaning duties for 2 days. Stevens will lose buy-ups for a week as well. Take them out, please, Miss Ferguson.
Certainly, Governor.
Well, even if the others did have some, they would have hidden it overnight.
Yes, a cell search would be nothing but a waste of time, no? However, there is another angle I could try.
Lizzie, you're standing in my light.
Wait till I get this bloody thing off my arm and then I'll show all you buggers what work's all about.
Oh, Lizzie, could you please help me with this? Because Minnie's going off with a skiff.
Very funny. Don't try and treat me like an idiot. Frieda's already out doing a run, and don't try and organise my life for me. Besides, me arm hurts.
She doesn't mean it, Pixie. Do you, Lizzie?
Ladies? Stevens has confessed to making the wine and swears there's no more in the prison. But my feelings tell me differently, so I've got a proposal to put to
you. Oh, yeah? What's that, Mrs. Reynolds?
An amnesty.
Oh, what's an amnesty? What are the terms, Mrs. Reynolds?
Mrs. Powell? A bin will be placed outside the recreation room for the next 24 hours. Any remaining wine can be left in there.
And who'll be spying on us when we do?
There'll be no guards posted in the area, and there'll be no punishments. But there is a catch. We're going to search the entire prison after the 24 hours. Anyone found with wine then will be severely dealt with.
Sounds fair enough. You can trust us, Mrs. Reynolds.
I know I can. That's why I'm doing it.
Do you reckon she means it?
Why not? She's got nothing to lose and everything to gain.
So how are your other patients? Giving you heaps?
Yeah, especially Phyllis.
Yeah, well, it wouldn't be like Phyllis if she wasn't whinging, eh?
No, all convalescents get a bit twitchy.
Oh, is she getting better?
Yeah, she'll be out this afternoon. Frances will be in a little while longer, though. Must have been one hell of a fight.
Well, Mary seemed to get the worst of it. She's still at the Wentworth Hospital.
Yeah.
Oh, I suppose she's enjoying the change. Speaking of the change, if that's what I've got, I'm not enjoying it.
Oh, I don't think your female obligations are over yet, Judy.
Obligations? Oh, Scott.
Now, for a number of reasons, your blood pressure's up. This, in turn, is putting a strain on the pacemaker. Now, if you don't start making a conscious effort to wind down, you'll be in deep trouble, Judy.
Yeah, well, I'm already in deep trouble, or had you forgotten?
No, I'm being serious. You need more rest. You're obviously not sleeping at night.
I can't. I keep thinking about Hazel's death. Every time I try to close my eyes, I can see her face.
Well, that's pretty natural, but it'll go away in time. Now, I'll give you something to help make you sleep.
Look, the only thing that's going to help me is for the jury to understand why I did it.
Yeah, I know that. Judy, I'll be appearing as a witness for the prosecution.
What? Oh, how could you do that? I mean, I thought you were going to be a character witness for me.
Yeah, I know that, but I'm afraid I don't have much choice. You see, I prescribed Hazel's drugs and left them in your care to administer, didn't I? I'm sorry, Judy, I really am.
Yeah, well, tell that to the judge.
An amnesty. That's like throwing meat to piranhas and hoping that they're vegetarians.
Yeah, well, I have reservations as well, but I don't think it's as devastating as you make out.
Oh, come on. Next thing they'll be sitting on the parole board.
Mrs. O'Shea's organising the bins.
Governor, about this amnesty.
It's worth a try, Miss Ferguson. If we can get the women to trust us, we may be able to concentrate on the jobs we're meant to be doing.
Yeah, well, what about discipline? Now, those women are just going to treat this as a game.
I disagree. Given time, they may stop viewing us as enemies if we stop viewing them as children.
Yeah, well, with respect, Mrs. Reynolds, I think it's futile to trust them this far.
Hear, hear.
Well, it's my decision to prove you wrong.
You're off your head if you believe her. Bet you as soon as you dump that grog in the bin, there'll be a screw grabbing you by the neck and dragging you off.
Bobby, you want people to give you a fair go, so practicing what you preach.
Well, you're okay. Reno knows you. We get sweet F.A. from her.
I knew Mrs. Reynolds a long time ago. She was okay then and she's okay now.
You reckon she's going a bit soft in the head? I mean, old Avo had never gone for all that amnesty stuff.
I reckon Mrs. Reynolds all right.
Oh, yes, I think I can trust her too.
You can't trust any screw, especially the top one.
Don't be such a stupid bitch, Bobby. You don't know what you're talking about. Mrs. Reynolds is a fair person. She'll treat you as you deserve to be treated.
Tell you what I'll do. To make it easier on everyone, I'll organise some real booze once we dump this plonk out.
Be a slap in the face for the freaking Sonia.
What sort of booze are you thinking of bringing in, then?
Oh, maybe a drop of scotch.
Real scotch? God, I'd give anything for some real scotch. I can keep all that other rotten muck.
You and your big mouth.
I know. Always was my problem. I won't back down, though.
Mrs. Powell, is this about my appeal?
Well, that isn't for me to say.
Would you like to explain, Scotty?
No, I don't think I really understand myself.
Dr. Collins and his wife, Mrs. Reynolds.
Mrs. Reynolds, why are we being seen together?
I felt it was appropriate under the circumstances.
Then it's about my appeal.
Yes, it's being upheld. A mistrial's been declared. You're free to go, Petra.
Double 174286, is that it?
Thank you. What a wonderful memory. I'll try not to disturb you, Mrs. Morris.
Oh, it's quite all right.
Here you go.
Oh, thank you, dear. Hello.
What is it? Oh, it's
Scott's. Oh, hello, dear. It's Auntie Min. How are you?
It is
a fiddle. Oh. Now, listen, I can't talk for long, but I do need to see you. Yes, this afternoon.
Right.
And bring Billy's bag, will you? Yes, nine of my little pick-me-ups. He'll know what I want.
Sorry.
All right, love, thanks. Look forward to seeing you. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Petra get on all right, Mrs. Powell?
Well, I think I'll let her tell you that, Donovan.
Thanks for the phone call. Just a few little details I need to see my solicitor about.
Right. Come on.
God, Sonia, I reckon it's awful. You having to slave away all day in here and then go and scrub floors for another 2 hours. Still, I suppose it's good for your figure. What do you reckon, Cass?
Oh, Min reckons there's nothing like hard work for getting a lot of bad wine out of your system.
Where's Pigs?
Oh, she's doing the pickup. Hey, are you sure you're okay to work, Phyllis?
Yeah. Lizzie, it really happened. No trial, no more questions. I've been released.
Oh, love, I'm so pleased.
That's real great, Petra. Hey, what happened?
My appeal was upheld and the charges were dismissed. They call it a mistrial.
Oh, jeez, I bet the doc's pleased.
Of course he is. Oh, I will miss you. You will try and keep in touch, won't you?
Of course I will.
Oh, what a pity Pixie isn't here. She could have had a good cry by now when she heard that news.
She already has. I met her in the corridor.
Pixie just told me. I'm so pleased for you, dear.
Thanks, Minnie. I'm going to try and get word to Bea. I know she'll be glad things have worked out this way.
Oh, well, if you do. Tell her all her old mates are thinking about her, won't you? Especially me.
Of course. You know, if Bea hadn't made me see sense, this may never have happened. So I've got her to thank, really. And all I have to do is try to forget the bad parts.
Oh, you'll never be able to do that, love. None of us can. But you've got a good bloke and a chance to make a good life, so you just grab onto that.
I will. And thanks for everything.
Bye. Well, now that the Hearts and Flower bit is over and done with, it's back to business. The numbers game is back on. Phyllis, start collecting. Something happened to your hearing during the accident. I said start collecting.
How about it?
Thanks, love.
Lizzie?
I'm a bit short at the moment.
Maybe we better tell them about the new rules. We've got a new set of prizes. $6 for first, $4 for second, and $2 for third. So how does that grab you?
Better than your last setup. What happened? Your conscience get to you or something?
I can do better than that, ladies. Double the cash prizes and a nice little bonus. A miniature of scotch for each of the lucky three winners.
Oh, God, I reckon I'll be in on that. I think I can scrape up enough. Just one lot.
You're
all
right, so
two men, lucky number six.
I'm sure you both know how happy we are things have turned out this way.
Thanks, Mrs. Reynolds. I just can't wait to be on the other side of those gates. But I'd just like to say thank you for all the support you've given us, and especially for our wedding.
Good luck.
Yes, to the two of you.
We won't expect you in tomorrow, Scott, unless there's an emergency.
Thanks. Come on, darling.
Bye.
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 Well, at least something cheerful's happened today. I had to tell Arthur Charlton Lizzie wants no further contact with the family.
She was so pleased about seeing.
Apparently the day was a disaster.
But they couldn't expect to hit it off the first time.
I know, but Lizzie's adamant. Mr. Charlton thinks it was mainly their fault. But unfortunately, she's not going to give them a chance to try again.
Well, 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 if it isn't the seven dwarves back from the mines for the day.
Shut up, Bobbie.
Oh, and here comes Snow White.
Talking to me, Mitchell?
No, Miss Ferguson.
Donovan, you've got a visitor.
Oh, lovely. See you later, Cass.
Oh, right, I'm in.
And Stevens, don't forget those extra duties.
Yeah, not my idea of a Jake either. Scrubbing them bloody corridors. Hey, listen, thanks for getting me off the hook about the booze.
We had a deal. I hope you haven't forgotten.
Of course not. Just beats me why you want to do it. I thought you and the freak were mates.
Partners, strictly business.
Yeah, so why do you want to tape her?
Because partners means equal risk, equal split all the way down the line. And Ferguson gets a little confused about that, so I need something to remind her. Call it an insurance.
Yeah, well, I'm not too excited about being the meat in the sandwich.
Why would she suspect you? Nearly all the women in here have tape recorders.
Yeah, but why me?
Because you're the one that's always walking around with your earphones on. You're the perfect setup. Besides, you owe me a favour, remember? Come on, Bobby, you got your head screwed on the right way, and I like that. You and I'd make a good team.
You got a partner?
We'll use her while it suits us, but we have to have the tape. You'd enjoy seeing someone get at it, wouldn't you?
Would I?
A deal?
You bet.
Oh, I don't know whether I could...
Just give it to Billy and stop worrying.
What if they search me?
Would I risk any of my kids' careers? And you know they don't search solicitors.
Yeah, I don't like it, Auntie Minnie.
Oh, Terry, you wouldn't begrudge me one little favour, would you?
Of course not.
Let's do it, then you'll breathe easier. Oh, good boy. Yeah? Turn your head while I get rid of them. Oh, where do you think I'm going to put them? Turn your head. And just make sure you tell Billy what I said. It's very important.
I wonder what Petra and Scott are doing now.
Can't you guess?
She said she'd keep in touch, but I bet she doesn't.
Why not?
Well, the only thing she had in common with us was that we were all stuck in here.
Come on, she's not like that.
I didn't say anything against her. I reckon she's one of the best. But once you're out there, well, it's them and us, and you can't get away from them.
Well, that's pretty strange coming from you.
Why?
Well, you've just discovered your own family.
The only family I got's in here.
What's up her nose?
I'm not sure, but I've got something that'll cheer up. A little drop of that scotch I mentioned.
Well, you better make sure that the word doesn't get round to the screws or they'll find out where you got it from.
All we've got to do is stall till tomorrow. Then they won't have a clue.
No flies on you either.
Donovan's bringing in her booze and we better match it else we'll be out of business.
No way.
You've got no choice.
You've got no choice. Now, you're so smart, I'm sure you'll think of something, Stevens.
Colleen tells me the bin's almost full.
The fact that it was pretty vile stuff may have helped a bit.
True. I notice we've been connected to the prison broadcasting service.
Yes, well, it's always seemed wrong to me that it was restricted to Barnhurst and Woodridge. Mind you, I can just imagine the sort of stuff we'll get. You better get ready for some pretty heavy censoring.
Well, we may discover a budding Shakespeare.
Oh, we may. It's official. Our new office is going to start this week.
Oh, good.
David Bridges from Woodridge.
Hmm.
Might have hit the jackpot there. And this is for Lizzie. Mr. Charlton dropped it in.
Oh. Might make her change her mind about visiting again.
Hope so. See you tomorrow.
Have a good night.
Bye.
You missed one.
Thank you, Lizzie.
Patience. Something I'm running short of. Isn't it time you made the draw, or can't you keep your promise?
I don't recall you buying any ticket. So it really isn't your problem, is it?
Well, I did, and I could do with a drop of that scotch right now.
Well, it's probably all talk, Lizzie. And the women are going to like that.
It is not. You did get it, didn't you, Min?
We'll be making the draw tomorrow when all the numbers are sold. Why don't you buy one? Help speed things up.
I hope for your sake you can put your money where your mouth is. If and when you do make the draw. Where's Phyllis?
Oh, she said she wasn't feeling well. I think she's gone to lie down.
Ladies, Mrs. Reynolds has asked me to pass on some good news. Wentworth is officially joining the prison broadcasting service.
Oh, beauty! We'll be able to send a message to me.
Well, you will be able to send messages and request your favourite records. And if there are any budding writers amongst you, you can get together and do some sketches and that sort of thing.
That opens up all sorts of possibilities.
Oh, yeah, sure, bulk fun.
Oh, it'll be just bonza.
Here's a letter from your son, is he?
Why aren't you going to open it? It looks as though it was personally delivered.
I reckon I should forget all about my son.
You all right? Perhaps you should get the doctor to check you over again.
Oh, I'm okay. Look, I'm sorry about the numbers, but I didn't have a hope of selling them.
I know, we're outmaneuvered. We'll just have to wait and see if she delivers.
Well, what if she does?
Don't worry. I'm not. You said you had a cassette recorder. Can I borrow it?
Yeah, but it's a real old cheapo. It's got a radio in it, but the sound's pretty crook. I hardly ever use it.
But it works.
Oh, yeah. It's pretty junky, though. This is it here. What do you want it for?
This. I promised to copy a couple of tapes.
Oh, you can try, but no guarantees.
Well, as you never use it, perhaps you'd like to sell it to me. Say, $25.
Oh, $25? I'll chuck in me old tapes as well.
It's a deal. Huh.
Lovely way to start the bloody day. How many more of these corridors we got to do anyway?
Just this one.
Yeah, well, she better show soon. I'm going around the twist with your music.
Just make sure she thinks it is your music. Now, the minute I get her talking, make sure you press that record button.
All right, what do you think, I am dumb or something?
Shh, she's coming. Miss Ferguson, this brush seems to have had it. Could you organise me with another one?
It'll last the day.
I think Donovan's bringing the booze in today. Well, don't worry about her. She can't hear a thing when she's plugged in. Did you find out who Donovan's visitor was yesterday?
Hey, just a solicitor.
She probably asked him to set it up. You know, if she goes through with it, it'll be the finish of our business.
You don't seem to have very much confidence in me, Stevens. If I can get rid of Smith, I really don't see how Donovan can be a challenge.
It's not a matter of confidence, Miss Ferguson. You're getting a major cut in this partnership. I figure it's time you earned it.
If you didn't have my protection, Stevens, you'd be out of business in 5 minutes, and you know it. These are clear to go.
Right. Can I help you?
Yes, I wonder if I could see Mrs. Donovan. I rang earlier.
Yeah, you must be Mr. Dorsey. Look, if you just sign in over here, I'll organise it for you.
Look, I'll see Mr. Dorsey through, if you like. You'll find Donovan in the laundry.
Thank you, Miss Ferguson. You're most helpful.
A friend of the family, are you?
Oh, I've known them for a long time.
Well, let's not keep Mrs. Donovan waiting. I'm sure she's very anxious to keep in touch.
How's Dorry, dear? Keeping busy?
Oh, you know Dorry. A finger in every pie. Couldn't stop talking about the new supermarket that's opened up. Came home with enough goodies to keep the family going for weeks.
Oh, she always was a good little manager and always did love the big shops.
You needn't worry about the family. They're all doing fine. They miss you, of course, Auntie, but Dorry's totally organised. Everything's running like clockwork.
Well, you tell them I'm fine, and I'm very proud the way they're keeping things going, and I certainly miss them. It's lovely seeing you, dear.
I had a word to your solicitor. He told me how things stand.
All these things take time. He's doing what he can, dear. We just have to be patient.
Yeah.
Time's up, Donovan.
Well, you don't get very long.
No, dear, but they're very nice to us on the whole. Well, bye-bye, dear. Come again.
No physical contact. Officer Radcliffe will see you out.
I see what you mean. Very helpful, too.
OK, Donovan, hand it over.
Pardon?
Let's just call it a routine search, shall we? Well, I don't think the governor's going to be too pleased with her old friend, is she? And I shouldn't imagine the other women would be too happy with you either.
I'm very disappointed in you, Donovan. You know the rules concerning alcohol.
Yes, it was a silly thing to do. But Billy's like a son to me. And he knows I like a drop of scotch in me milk to help me sleep. I didn't want to hurt his feelings.
Well, he may be a lot more distressed if he knows that as a result, you're losing privileges for a week. Maybe you'd better warn him. The consequences could be a lot worse if it happens again.
Oh, it won't, Mrs. Reynolds. I give you my word.
Good.
Would it be possible to have a private word with you, Mrs. Reynolds?
Donovan, you've just lost privileges. This isn't the time to ask for favours.
It's all right, Miss Ferguson. Wait outside, please.
Certainly, Governor.
Now, I've only got a few moments. What is it?
I'm worried about the women in here. Oh, I know you do your best. So do most of the officers. But what happens to them when they leave Wentworth?
We liaise with welfare. Their probation officers do the best they can.
Yes, I know about that. But the trouble is, they don't learn anything here. So when they get out, it's back to crime, and bingo, back into Wentworth.
I know, Minnie. I'd give my eye teeth to solve the problem, but, well, it's not as easy as all that. The last governor organised all sorts of classes, but none of them succeeded, I'm afraid.
But I'm talking about something practical, like typing classes, for instance. And you won't have any trouble getting typewriters. I've got a contact that can get you any amount.
I'm sure he can, but I think you should leave that to us.
Does that mean we can do it?
Oh, now, hang on. I'd have to see how the department feels.
Well, while you're at it, tell him that one of my girls will teach the classes gratis. Oh, until one of our women can take over. I know how the minister hates parting with his money.
Okay, Minnie, leave it with us.
I think it'd be a nice gesture, now that the women have responded so well to your faith in them. And there's not a bottle of wine left in the building.
And I appreciate their cooperation. I just hope we don't find any more scotch bottles.
You all right, Lizzie?
Of course I am. Can't anyone have a quiet think without everybody sticking their tuppence in?
Yeah, righto, righto, Lizzie. I'm sorry. Didn't mean to make you mad.
Seems Donovan isn't going to deliver. She got sprung in the scorching.
Ferguson?
I think we're making business partners.
Would you two stop hissing and whispering? It's getting on my nerves. Anyway, you're not supposed to be back in here yet.
Now, Lizzie, what's your blood pressure?
Oh, g'day, Min. Hey, what the governor want?
Not much, love. We just had a nice little chat. Oh,
yeah.
Yes, and you'll all be glad to hear there are going to be some changes.
There certainly will be, unless you live up to the little bonuses that you promised.
Oh, I'm glad you reminded me, dear. The numbers draw.
Oh, hooray!
Come on, Cass, you pick the lucky winners.
Number 7.
Hey, that's Pixie. Oh, gee, she gets lucky, doesn't she?
Oh, look.
You are, Lizzie. You mind, that's Pixie. Now the next.
Number 29.
Oh, that's... Hey. Oh, well. Oh, this will get you into A1 condition, Phyllis.
Hey, Lizzie, it's yours. You want Lizzie number 18?
What a pity you didn't buy a ticket, Sonia. You might have got lucky for once. I think I should spike your tea with a casserole. Oh, yeah. I reckon it was your lucky fingers that did it.
Yeah, well, that's real nice of you, Lizzie, but only a little bit.
I want a word with you. Well, you're not quite as clever as you thought you were, are you?
Just keep your voice down. Now, what the hell are you on about, Stevens?
Donovan's handed out the scotch.
Rubbish, I confiscated it.
Just as she planned, probably already had the supply.
How the hell would she have got it in here?
Think again, Ferguson. She's just handed it out. Well, losing your touch, boss lady. Well, you've just earned yourself a demotion. From now on, you bring the supplies in from the outside and I'll make sure there aren't any more slip-ups.
Don't you push me too far, Stevens.
I don't think I need to push you at all. In fact, I think you'd be quite happy to do as I say.
We're getting a merger captain's partnership. I figure it's time to move it.
If you didn't have my protection, Stevens, you'd be out of business in 5 minutes and you know it.
And of course, there's more than that.
Just how far did you think you'd get with this, Stevens?
Pity you're ruining it. Never mind, I've got some more copies. So you do as I say. Or else one of the tapes goes to the governor, and another one just like it to the department. Do we have a deal? Ferguson.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down, but the sun and rain are prisoners too. Around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground. The roses here are prisoners too, when morning comes around.